I've been working with a group called WADA, which is the World Anti-Doping Association. They were formed in response to drug abuse among Olympic athletes originally. So originally they were formed to sort of police the Olympics and try to catch substance abusers that were trying to use performance-enhancing substances and then compete. One of the things WADA routinely screens for is people's hematocrit, the amount of red blood cells that they have per unit volume of blood, because that's really an easy way to sort of get a hint that maybe something's going on here that's not natural. We were showing that you could use these viruses, AAV, to boost the levels of IGF-1, and IGF-1 is sort of a muscle building substance. It's the way the muscle naturally signals to increase its own size. We showed that if you use the virus to make the have the muscle make more IGF-1, then the muscles got bigger in young animals, and also they didn't get smaller when the animals got old. My initial interest was not in athletes and not in muscular dystrophy, it was in aging. It was to try to stop the muscle weakness that occurs as we get old. Society will want that. I mean, and once society is doing that for its elderly, then how do you stop the athletes from doing it? Because you can't say you're not allowed to have this thing that's going to benefit you as you get older. If a government were committed to making it happen for their athletes, they could do it right now. The question is it being done? And is it being done in such a way that WADA's detection methods will or will not pick it up? But if it proves safe and it proves effective, and if it makes it into the geriatric population at some point, then there's no way to stop the athletes from doing it, at least no ethical way. And so I think then it becomes a huge dilemma for all the sports authorities.